We are the Hebrew Israelites.
You gotta say that shit loud, dog.
We come in week in and week out, prophesy against this wicked kingdom. Tell your people before it comes that America's going into, it's gonna be destroyed by nuclear fire. And to tell the Negroes, Latinos, and Native Americans that they're the true Israelites of the Bible. And we're gonna tell you all of this according to the Bible.
Matthew 13:9. It says, "Who hath ears to hear, let him hear."
I'm gonna get the camera, but I'm I get some precepts.
The disciples came and said unto him, "Why speakest thou unto them in parables?" He answered and said unto them, "Because it is given unto you to know the mysteries of the kingdom of heaven, but to them it is not given."
Right. His disciples asked, you know, Yahawashah, people called Jesus, so-called people now call so-called Jesus, his real name is Yahawashah.
Right.
His disciples asked him, "Oh, why do you speak to them in parables?" Because Yahawashah just was talking to a large gathering of people, and he just spoke a parable to them,
right,
like a metaphor. And so his disciples asked, you, these people are not going to get it. So Yahawashah is basically telling them that only a select few people is going to get the real knowledge and the real truth. It's not going to be available to everybody. Like the Baptist churches want to have you to believe. And just overall, this white man just wants you to believe everybody can get saved, or basically everybody. Only a select few is going to know the real knowledge of the Bible. And that's the ones the Lord has chosen from the beginning. Yeah, peace out.
We got a precept. Sirach chapter 6, verse 22. "For wisdom is according to her name, and she is not manifesting to many."
Right. It is. Wisdom is not manifested unto many. She gonna be selective with her choosing. So every pastor you see, and every wise guy in this world, and he has the philosophy of the majority of the world, and people consider him wise, he's probably not really wise. If the majority follow him, only a select few. The knowledge that you would think is what's the word I'm looking for? Is garbage, is really the knowledge that you're supposed to have.
Got another precept.
You got something? Yeah.
This is Job chapter 30.
Hold on.
1 Corinthians chapter 2, verse 6. "Howbeit we speak wisdom among them that are perfect, yet not the wisdom of this world, nor of the princes of this world that come to naught. But we speak the wisdom of God in a mystery."
Right. See, the princes of the world that come to naught, what I said before. The guys who you think of this world, the top leaders like Jesse Jackson,
right,
Obama, the Scientology,
the head of,
yeah, the wise, the superstars of this world, Will Smith, etc., etc. The princes of the world. But their knowledge, what did it say? That comes from God.
It says, "Nor of the princes of this world that come to naught, but
right,
we speak the wisdom of God in mystery, even the hidden wisdom which God ordained before the world unto our glory."
Right, before the world unto our glory. So this wisdom, that verse shows you that it was already here before even the prophets, before the prophets came on the planet. For our glory, this is the only thing we have left in this society, this wisdom. and knowledge that even the princes of this world don't have.
Go into it. All right. It says, which none of the princes of this world knew.
Right.
But had they known it, they would not have crucified the Lord of glory.
Right. See? If everybody knew, if everybody know what we know, the world would be perfect, man. And yeah. You had something up?
No, I'm saying like that's never a priority
for her. Oh. Yeah. Got it.
Alright.
Job chapter 32 verse 8. But there is a spirit in man, and the inspiration of the Almighty giveth them understanding.
Right. All this wisdom that's upon us, the men of the Lord, the prophets of the world all over the planet, is through the inspiration of God, whose real name is Yahweh. That's where our knowledge comes from. That's why we speak in the authority and the confidence that you see, and we out here in the streets, and we out argue and outsmart anyone through the inspiration of Yahweh. All the scholars, all the professors, all the lawyers, all the pastors and the professionals, the priests, we outdo all of them through the inspiration of Yahweh.
Romans 11:7. It says, what then? Israel have not obtained that which he seeketh for, but the election have obtained it.
Right. Israel talking about the majority of the Negroes, Latinos, Native Americans.
Right.
They haven't, even though they got a zeal for the Lord, they go to churches and try to understand the knowledge on a certain level, but not on a high level. They don't get it. Even though they try, they're just not gonna get it because they're not pre-selected from the beginning.
They said, and the rest were blinded.
Right. They're not gonna get it, man. They're just not gonna get it. They can't even perceive it, man. It's right in front of their face. A lot of people just walk past, right, like they don't even see us, like we're invincible. Like the fucking zombies, man, like the fucking said. They don't even see us most of the time. You got some up?
According as it is written, God hath given them the spirit of slumber. Eyes that they should not see, and ears that they should not hear unto this day.
Sleep. It was happening back then, and it's happening now. They sleep. They have no senses available. Well, no.
You got none.
Yeah.
Which goes to show you too, like I said. Read this again. It says, according as it is written, and this is written beforehand, God have given them the spirit of slumber, eyes that they should not see, and ears that they should not hear unto this day. And that should go to show you that the Most High already don't want these people, man. If he did, why would he give them that spirit? Why did he ordain people to actually have the spirit of slumber? Like, if you got that spirit of slumber, there really ain't shit you can do about it, man. Just like if you ordained to come out there and teach his word, you ain't got nothing, you got no choice. So you gotta understand, like, coming into this thing, it's just gonna be people, I'm gonna say this, it's gonna be a majority of people, they just don't care, man. They're not gonna care. They're not gonna get it. They're gonna hear it. They're gonna fan their hands. They rather believe in, you know, like the one chick that was up here, Evolution. You know, they believe in it, you know, they science or whatever. Even though science comes from, was orchestrated from the Most High. But they just, they already had that spirit of slumber. So you really can't wake that person up. That's why it says slumber. Slumber is actually a deep, deep sleep, man. They didn't say they were just, you know, napping. You know what I mean? They gonna wake up as a slumber, man. That's on the lines of like a hibernation. They're not gonna get it, man. That's why we come out here week in, week out, because this is what we commanded to do. But we not coming out here thinking that, oh shit, we gotta wake up everybody, man. Everybody just gotta wake up. Everybody just gotta listen to us and take heed. No, it don't work like that.
You gotta evangelize everybody.
Right. Like the Christians say, what do they call it? Evangelical?
Yeah, evangelical.
Evangelical, you know, duties. Now let's be real, a lot of them motherfuckers, they just doing it for game, man. You know what I'm saying? They doing that for game.
I got a precept too.
Go ahead, huh?
You done? 2 Edges chapter 9 verse 1. He answered me then and said, measure thou the time diligently in itself, and what thou seest part of this signs past, which I have told thee before, then shalt thou understand that it is the very same time wherein the highest will begin to visit the world which he made.
If I could speak on this real quick.
If you notice, it says the highest shall visit the world. And that's good that it says that, because some people don't understand why he's called the Most High. He's called the Most High because he's the most highest judge or power. All right, there's other judges and powers or gods. There's many gods, man. We're gods. You know? The angels are gods. You know, and the word God means judge or power. But the highest judge or power, the one that rules supreme over all judges and powers, is the Most High, what you call God or Yahweh. When you say God and you say Most High, that's what that means. The highest judge. That's all it means. All right? You got something to say? You want to say?
Read that. Read that last part.
It says, thou seest the part. Oh, it says, then shalt thou understand. He answered me then and said, measure thou the time diligently in itself. And when thou seest part of the signs past, which I have told thee before, then shalt thou understand that it is the very same time wherein the highest will begin to visit the world which he made.
Wait a minute, so it said measure the time diligently. And then it said, what about understand?
It says, then shalt thou understand that it is the very same time wherein the highest will begin to visit the world which he made.
So wait a minute.
When the signs pass.
When the signs pass. So, but wait a minute. You're not gonna even know about it because you ain't even looking for it. You're not looking at the signs, man. Because first of all, you don't care. A lot of y'all don't care. That's how you know that scripture right there was actually talking about the elect. It was actually written for the elect. But why would he say, measure the time diligently and stuff, man? Because wait a minute. Yahweh Shah told us to look for the times. These people not looking for the times. And they're not going to understand it. That's why they're going to be searching for us in that day. That's the most sought out thing, is understanding. But they say that's the most top, that's the most searched thing in Google, is how to, or understanding of how. They did statistics on what people do on Google, and that's one of the main things, is how to, or understanding of this. Oh, they say the information highway. This is the information highway right here, on the highways and byways. Come up here for information. We're like the Most High Google, if you will. If you want to know something, you come to the prophets, man.
And most high willing, we'll be able to give you that answer. But you know what? Jake don't care, though. That's how we know that blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans are the children of Israel, because they don't care. You got Esau, other nations and everything coming up here.
You got a scripture to back you up by that Google thing.
You got it up.
I'm interested in what you guys are.
Isaiah chapter 50.
What is that?
We're the Israelites. We believe we're trying to get our people back to all their heritage. Latinos, Negroes, Native Americans.
But the Bible, you're Jewish?
Bible. We're Jews. Yeah, it's Jewish.
You're Jews from Israel?
Yeah,
you're
blood. Bloodline.
Yeah, so you're Israelite Jews.
Yeah, right.
Were you born in Israel? No.
Not in this lifetime.
No.
But it doesn't matter where you're. It doesn't matter where you believe it. It matters where you're born.
Where your blood goes.
Yeah.
Right. Okay. Yeah. Okay. So you're.
Yeah, if we was born over there in China, we wouldn't be Chinese.
No, so, I got you. Okay. Yeah. Okay. But your bloodline is Israelite Jews. Are all of you guys, like all of y'all, are?
Yeah.
And so the Jews migrated to West Africa. From Israel.
Yeah, 70 AD, since 9 AD. That was the Romans.
You mind if I get this out?
Yeah.
Alright, so basically what happened is in 70 AD, General Vespasian and General Titus besieged Jerusalem in this area right here. At that time, many of the Jews fled. And where did they flee? I'm gonna ask you a question, see if you know. Where did Joseph flee? Where did Joseph flee from? Was it Herod? Do you know where he took baby Jesus at?
I know. Okay, let me wait.
You got it. It's on the tip of your tongue.
No. Nazareth? No.
No.
Capernaum?
No. Can you guess?
Judea?
Egypt.
Egypt, okay.
Took him to Egypt.
All right.
But during 70 AD, when the Romans came down and besieged Jerusalem, the Israelites fled to Egypt.
Okay.
Now, Egypt, it was Egypt and Carthage. It was in this area. You know, you ever heard of Hannibal?
No.
You heard him, right? When Hannibal had the Punic Wars with the Romans, and there was a lot of war in this area here, the Jews then fled from there to Ethiopia and clear across Africa till they got here.
Okay.
And from here, they would pick up, they would take him.
Now, were these
slavery.
Jews, were these Jews, Christian Jews, like Jew Messianic, they were, you know, were they believing in Christ or they, no?
Now, let me give you the understanding of a Jew. A Jew, first of all, Jew is a tribe. It's like
a tribe. Yeah.
It's a bloodline. All right, there were 12 tribes of Israel. Israel was a man, he had a son. He had 12 sons, okay? Those sons were called tribes. So when you hear Jew, it's from Judah, which is a tribe. He had Benjamin, Levi, Simeon, these were all tribes. So these were Jews according to their blood.
Okay.
According to their...
And Jesus came down through which one of those tribes?
Jesus was a Jew. He came through the tribe of Judah.
Okay.
So he was what you would call a Judite.
Okay.
Now, some of these Jews believed in who you call Jesus, and some didn't. But that's a faith. That's a belief.
Okay.
What we're talking about here...
Has he come or not come?
Yeah.
But we're just talking about the people.
Right now, we're just talking about the bloodline. What we're showing you is that the Jews or the Israelites fled from Israel to Africa and then all the way to here. And they were taking it from here into slavery. And that's why we're telling you that we're Jews. I'm not actually a Jew, I'm a Benjamite. But people know the Israelites
well,
as Jews.
Well, because Jew is a race and a religion, right?
No.
Jewish, no?
No. Jew, like I told you, is from Judah, which is a tribe.
Okay.
Now, I think it's in the 7th century, the Khazarian king adapted or converted to what you call Judaism. Judaism is a religion that was based off the practices of the original Jews. But in order to describe what the original Jews practiced, their way of life, you would call it Judaism. So it became a religion, but it was originally a tribe with customs.
Okay.
You understand? Does that explain it to you?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
That the father of which is Abraham?
Abraham, Isaac,
Jacob,
Joseph. And then you had Joseph, which is one of the tribes, Judah, Benjamin, Levi, uh-huh. Simeon,
and they weren't a religious people?
They weren't, we wouldn't say they were religious. They did have a God.
Bloodline.
They were a bloodline. But they did have practices of believing in a certain God and keeping certain laws.
Heritage.
But they had, yeah, a heritage, uh-huh. so to speak. Just like in America, you have your constitution,
well,
right?
They kept the law, was that before the law of Moses?
Actually, the law of Moses goes all the way back even to the time of Adam.
Right, so that...
It says Abraham kept the laws.
Right, he kept the law.
It's those, but those laws are just like America has laws, right? And you have a judicial system, right? Those are the same things, but in the ancient times, they kept the laws and they wrote them in a book. It's like you have a code book in America. It's just that now it's in the Bible and people recognize it as a religion. But it was the same thing. It was a governmental system.
Hi, good. How are you? We're with James Christmas Party. Good to see you.
Yeah, but it was a government. It was a governing system of laws, just the same as America has a governing system of laws. It wasn't a religion. It was. Custom. No.
Abraham ready to sacrifice his son. Mm-hmm.
That was a faith.
That was for a code of law, not a faith in God.
No, not that part. What you mean? You mixing it up. I'm trying to get you to understand. Let's say 2,000 years from now, right? Let's say you're in a book that somebody wrote about your life. Let's say you believe in God, right? But let's say you never ran a stop sign. You never ran a stoplight. And they wrote that down. Thou should not run a stoplight or a stop sign. Would you say that's a religion?
No.
But you would say it's a law, right? Now, if you believed in Jesus, right, and I was a part of your so-called religion, would you say that was a religion? Yeah, right?
Yeah.
You believe? Now, if they put all of these things in the book, would you say that book is a religion? Everything? Or would you say part of it is a religion, and part of it is codes and laws?
Okay.
You understand?
Yeah.
That's how the Bible is. It has the Chronicles and the lines of King David. Those are just like your list of presidents. The same thing.
Okay.
That's just like you have a list of presidents. Israel had a list of kings, and they wrote it down in the Bible.
Okay.
So part of it, you could say, you could, if you want to call it that, you could say it's a religion.
But a lot of it's custom.
A lot of it is custom, okay. Yes.
So, and what is your purpose standing out here then? What are you wanting people to know and learn and understand?
Our purpose is this. Our people have been told, can you give me Hosea chapter 1, verse 10? You can still hold this up. Our people have been told that they are African American because when they were taken into slavery, they came from here. So they're told
and
automatically.
What year are we talking about that you're talking about? When?
1492.
Oh, okay.
Well, around that time, we were here in Africa and we were taken from Africa and brought to America. But because we were here, people automatically assume that those people are African. And so we still hold that name.
They're Israelites. I see.
That's why I have all of this heat.
Right.
Right here, this
like
guy.
Like a lot of black people say African American. No, they're not all.
They're Israelites.
Yeah, they're
Israelites. What we're saying is that the black people in America that came on slave ships are Israelites.
A lot of them.
Not all of them,
not
you're
all.
Correct. A lot of them.
Because there were people already existing here.
True. That's
that
true.
That didn't come from.
Yeah.
But this is the thing. When you go into the records, I have it all here. When you go into the records, there were different patches in Africa, different tribes. Some were native, some were what you would call Israelites or Jews. And the natives knew who the Jews were because they called them the strange people because they kept these strange customs of circumcision and different things like that. So they knew who they were. Now, when you had the slave trade, you hear people say, you guys were selling each other to the so-called white men. Those were the natives going and kidnapping the Israelites, the strange people, and selling them on the coast to the Europeans.
Uh-huh. Well, because a lot of black people in America don't even know, really, that they might be.
They don't know. A lot of them don't even know that they come from Africa.
They don't know their true heritage.
Exactly. So that's what we're out here for. You got it?
Yeah.
Read it real quick. 1 and 10.
What is this?
Hosea 1 and 10.
By design, too. They don't know.
Okay.
Hosea 1 and 10. Yet the number of the children of Israel shall be as the sand of the sea,
right,
which cannot be measured nor numbered.
Meaning Israel is a big nation. They can't even be numbered. They're big. Now I'm going to tell you something else. Some people that look white are really Israelites. Israelites don't just look like this.
Yeah.
There's some people in America that might think they're Irish. And they're really Israel because Israel is scattered all over the world.
Right.
You understand?
The nation of Israel right now might be small, but its people have gone throughout.
Not the nation. The nation is big because certain people don't know they're Israel.
Yes.
A lot of African Americans don't know that they're Israel. Yes. That's what they call them. A lot of people, like people from Europe, like Italians, the Moors were in Italy. A lot of the Moors were Israelites. Uh-huh. So there's a lot of people in Italy that might look white, but they're really Israel when they trace their blood all the way back.
Okay, I'm sorry, I interrupted.
Go ahead.
And it shall come to pass that in the place where it was said unto them, ye are not my people, there shall be said unto them, ye are the sons of the living power.
Read that part again, ye are not my people.
In the place where it was said unto them, ye are not my people, there shall be said unto them, ye are the sons of the living God.
So what are we doing? We're telling the people, because in this place, when they came on with chains and slavery, they were told that they, first of all, they were, what was it, 3/5 of a man? It wasn't even a man. Not only that, they weren't God's people. That's what they were told. They were told that they're African Americans. So in this place where they were told that they weren't God's people, we're now telling them that you're God's people, you're Israel. So that's our whole sole purpose, is to come tell them who they are. But the other thing is,
now you're not telling just black people that are walking by who they are.
We're telling them
everybody
Israel.
Yeah.
We're telling Israel who they are.
And are you trying to get people to realize that you are God's people? You're just not a nobody.
Not everybody, though.
Okay.
Not everybody, because...
But how do you know, walking by here, who are you deciding to tell?
We're throwing the line out there, and whoever God decides to bring in, that's who he brings in. We can't tell. I can't tell if you're Israelite or not by looking at you.
No.
You might look like a white woman, but you might be Israelite. Your blood might go back. So I can't just say, hey,
and
you.
Does that matter?
What?
How does it matter if I...
The bloodline?
I got a scripture for what she was talking about.
All right, go ahead.
Romans 8 and 15. I started at 15. It says, for ye have not received the spirit of bondage again to fear, but ye have received the spirit of adoption, whereby we cry, Abba, Father. The spirit itself beareth witness with our spirit that we are the children of God. And if children, then heirs of God, and joint heirs with Christ. If so be that we suffer with him, that we may be also glorified together.
That's it. Read that part again. Our spirit bear witness.
Right. It says the spirit itself bear witness with our spirit that we are the children of God.
So I can't just look at your flesh and say, nah, you're not an Israelite.
Right.
I have to go by your spirit to be able to tell if you're Israelite or not.
Right.
So that's what we're doing. Any other questions?
Yeah, but even if I weren't an Israelite, I'm adopted into the family of God by faith.
Why would you say that?
Because is it only the Israelites that are the children of God?
I let the Bible answer. Romans 9 and 3. It says, for I could wish that myself were accursed through Christ, but my brethren, my kinsmen, according to the flesh, who are Israelites, to whom pertain the adoption.
So when you get adopted in, that pertains to Israel. Go ahead, because, and I'll explain it to you. The reason why Israel would need an adoption is because if you go into Lamentations, if you go into the Old Testament, God did it. He told them that they're not his people no more. That's what he told them. If we read Hosea 1 and 9, it would have said that, but I didn't tell them to read that. But God told his people,
you're not my people no more because you're not listening to me. You're not right. keeping my laws.
Right.
So then that means that they would need to be adopted back to God. So that's why. What does it mean? It means that he must come. I'll give you another example. I'm trying to explain a whole lot in a simplified way. What is happening in the scriptures is this. God told his people, you're no longer my people. Jesus Christ came to bring all the people back together, to bring God back to his people so that they would be one. Why did he do this? Because there must be a place where the laws go forth so that everybody can learn how to worship God the correct way. Israel are the priests of God. They're his special chosen people. Why? Is it because they're beautiful, because they can do things that other people can't do? No. It's because he chose them, not even that. It's because he chose them to be a priest for him to the other nations. So the other nations must go to Israel to learn. That's why they're special.
All right. Special, yes. The only ones saved, is that what you're saying?
Yes.
No.
What are they saved from?
No, because Jesus, the disciples went out, and the Gentiles were filled with the Holy Spirit and began to speak in other tongues. And the Jews were shocked that the Holy Spirit didn't fall only upon their people, but upon everyone that declared the name of Jesus.
Acts chapter 2, I think it is. Yeah,
and
go ahead and get that.
How can you say that God plays favorites? Yes, they were chosen people. Are you saying that upon when Christ returns again, that only the Israelites are going to heaven and be saved?
That's not what I'm saying. Okay. What I'm saying is this. You got to understand the Bible. There's a reason for Jesus Christ coming. And it's not just to come save everybody. It's to come save his people so that his people can then bless all the other nations. That's why he said his people was going to be a blessing to all the nations. But he must first come save his people. It's like this. If you wanted to set up a school, right? Would you first get the students to come to the school, or would you set up the administration? You set up the administration, right?
I'm very confused by what you guys are saying. I don't understand what you are.
The example,
Are you Christians?
We're Christians in the sense that we follow who you call Christ. But are we Christians in the?
Are you Messianic Jews?
Who believe in
Do you believe that Jesus is a savior?
Yes. The Savior of Israel.
Only the Savior of Israel. Different teaching. I've never heard this before.
Then that's religion right there, because the world teaches that he came to save everybody. Like you heard John 3:16?
No. Well, a lot of scripture says all who call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved.
That's a good one. Acts.
Right.
Okay. And Jesus, it showed that after he said that after he got the comfort of the Holy Spirit will come, and it fell on everyone. It didn't fall on just the Jew, but the Greek. And so why,
this is the biggest misconception, because you're actually right, what you're saying. But the thing about it is, when you hear the word Gentiles...
You want me to hold it for you?
Trust me, I believe I found out he was a Jew. I didn't find that out until after I married him. Because his mother's name was Cohen, but she dropped her faith after the Holocaust, and they came over here, and they dropped it to Curtis. So he was actually a Jewish line, and if I have some Jewish friends and they say, Cohen is, but it's kind of highly esteemed in the Jewish regard or whatever. But so I believe, Jesus was a Jew, and his people were the chosen people.
Mm-hmm.
But I'm just trying to figure out what it is that you're...
Let me explain it to you after he read this. I'll explain to you after this.
Because once I leave here and walk away, how can I research what it is that you guys are all about? Are you Jews?
Israelites?
Are you Israelite Jews? Are you Christian Jews? Are you inclusive? Are you inclusive of the world, or are you exclusionary?
Israelites. All the other other stuff, like people say black people Israelites or Messianic Israelites. That's all it is. All these other names and denominations that just confuse.
How do you know?
You just read.
Well, how do you know? Because you're black.
You read it. From the spirit. It was prophesied.
Your spirit bears witness.
Right. It was prophesied that there would be prophets out here teaching his word.
Okay. So you feel in your spirit that God's spirit is bearing witness.
That's when we come out here. We can't be done.
Is she asking you personally or is she asking about all of this?
I just told you.
Hold on, bro. Let her talk.
I'm gonna ask it up because she's questioning.
All right, hold on.
Hold on.
Yo, hey, hold on, bro. Hold on.
No, and believe me,
talking to him.
Hold on, man. You're right.
I'm not doing
this. You're right.
Judgment. It's not judgment.
I want to learn. All right, this is Acts 2:21. And this shall come to pass.
I wouldn't be sitting here talking because I'm not here trying to tell you.
I know, I missed it. This is going to answer what you had said earlier, too.
It is. And it shall come to pass that whosoever shall call on the name of the Lord shall be saved.
They said, whoever shall call on the name of the Lord shall be saved. That's everybody, right?
So that's Israelites, Christians,
Hebrews.
Ye men of Israel, hear these words.
Say, go ahead.
Jesus of Nazareth, a man approved of God among you by miracles and wonders and signs, which God did by him in the midst of you, as ye yourselves also know, him being delivered by the determinate counsel and foreknowledge of God, ye have taken and by wicked hands have crucified and slain, whom God have raised up, having loosed the pains of death.
That's it. So it said, ye men of Israel, hear these words.
You got precept too, man.
So what is your message
to you?
What is your message to the white girl walking by? I want the message. No, I want it
for you. Isaiah 58:1.
What is your message to me?
This is going to be my message right here. Give me a Revelations 2.
Revelation 1. 2:10?
No. All right, I got it.
Revelation 2:3-24. Behold, I stand before God. Anyone that hears my voice and opens the door.
See, you gotta understand this book. When it's anyone of Israel, you have to remember who this book was given to. Remember, we just said this is the heritage of the Israelites. So they're not gonna always say, all right, this and that, Israel. Even though he does say it sometimes, but every time it's not gonna always say Israel because it's already written to the Israelites. That's where you got all these books from. It's already assumed. It's already in there. He doesn't have to keep reiterating it. The Corinthians.
John 3:16 is not going to explain to you what they're trying to explain to you. Like, it's different understanding. It's precept on precept. You know what I'm saying? Like, you gotta do your reading. You know what I'm saying? 2 Timothy 2:5 tells you, like, you gotta prove yourself by studying. If you're not studying, 2:15, my bad. 2 Timothy 2:15.
I got scripture for you too. For them Gentiles.
I said earlier, I didn't even take the question. You know? And that's why I was trying to like get out of here. Like, who would you ask this?
What is it?
Do you?
This is about the Gentiles.
That's the thing. Do you believe in God? Why so?
This is the thing. We're reading out of the King James 1611 Bible. So all of this what we're saying is in the Bible. Now, I don't know if you read the Bible Do you read the Bible? Do you read it a lot?
Not as much as I should.
This is our life. This is all we do. We can't tell you, look, we believe in who you call God. We can't sit here and lie to you. We can't tell you what we believe. So that's why he says reading out of the Bible. It might be strange to you, but to be honest with you, a lot of the things that are being said these days are not true. The things that are being promoted massively, I can't think of the word, but the things that are popular, that are being said, that's popular, may not necessarily be the truth. Now, it might be strange to you, but it was also strange when the prophets went out and started to teach the people of the things that they taught. When Jesus Christ went out and he taught, that was strange to those people. So you gotta be open-minded and think, maybe this might be true, because when Jesus went out, that was strange. When the prophets went out and the things that they said, that was strange to them, to people. People wanted to kill the prophets for the things that they said. Now the things that we're telling you the truth, whether we want to tell you that or not. Whether we feel compassion or anger.
I know, but when it says all who call the name of the Lord, all.
The men of Israel.
It doesn't mean me.
I got some.
It doesn't mean me.
Because
I call upon the name of the Lord Jesus Christ as my Savior.
Because what we're telling you,
he's not my Savior, he's only your Savior.
That's the Gentiles?
Yeah.
Hold up.
He's only your Savior?
He's only the God of Israel, like you said.
But you gotta, understand why. You gotta understand why. Give me Sirach 11 and 7.
Jesus said, who is my mother?
Those that do the will of God.
Immaculate conception isn't real. So if they don't believe that immaculate conception actually happened.
Let me talk to her.
Immaculate conception. And Mary was pregnant by spirit. She's from the house of Judah.
Says so what? David. 11
David
and 7.
Got Mary pregnant. That's what happened. She's from the house of Judah.
Yeah. So 11 and 7.
David. Right.